Over on our Instagram account, we opened a submissions box for you to submit your builds to us. And today in this video, we've picked out 8 of our favorites, one of which even includes an instrument that I think is it's pretty revolutionary, let's put it that way. So let's get into it. So we are gonna jump over to France and we're gonna go visit my pal Virgil at Blind Guitars on Instagram. Make sure you go check him out and give him a follow. And he has sent over this absolutely jaw-dropping Gibson L3 inspired arch top. Black top. Thing to say about Virgil is his finish work is absolutely impeccable. He also has the most ridiculous wood stash. Getting Pernambuco is difficult enough. Getting it flamed is just like, I just love that aesthetic. Just really beautiful with the abalone trim. So nice. Tailpiece, chef's kiss. So let's give it a little listen, shall we? So the voice on this is absolutely incredible. It's like a real hybrid. You've got the kind of jazz guitar in there, you've got some gypsy jazz elements to it as well, with the loud, kind of powerful voice of the modern flat top acoustic guitar. Really, really lovely. All right, over to Quebec. We're gonna go see my very dear friend, absolute legend, Michel Pellerin. 25 years of experience. He was the foreman at Godin Guitars, worked in the finishing shop, taught me how to finish guitars. Hundreds and hundreds of guitars under his belt. Safe to say he knows what he's doing. So let's have a look at what Michel has sent in. Come on. I mean, where do you even start with something like that? Harp guitars always blow my mind. Like, I just have no idea how you even go about conceptualizing something like this. And then executing it in the way that Michel does is just next level. And again, another expert finisher. Let's give this one a listen. Super cool guy too. Incredible. Unbelievable instruments. All right, another amazing builder. Recently picked up this book, Guitar, The Shape of Sound. And in here is one of Nikolai Shaw's guitars. And he is just a pioneer. Here's Nikolai's work, the owl in this book. Guitar, The Shape of Sound. This guitar, I believe, is called The Future, and you can kind of see why. This is just a really radical instrument, made using non-tropical timbers, milk paints, chalk paints, everything's natural, everything is handmade, hand-wound pickups, which kind of slide all about the place to give you all different tones and all this kind of thing. I mean, it's even got a blackboard on the back, you know, when you want to write down your musical ideas. So let's give The Future a listen. I don't think I've actually heard this guitar, so I'm quite intrigued. Super unique sound. It's almost like it's got like a, is that like a fretless section in the middle? Hats off, Nikolai, you've done it again. Amazing. Beautiful, love that recording. So next up we've got David at Salts Guitars. I've actually mentored David for a little while. He's Salts Guitars on Instagram. He's been building 2 years full time, but 6 years in total. And let's have a look at these guitars. These are very cool, very different. Boom, love that. Really interesting shape, using a Wenge neck. We've got some, I believe that's Crelacam ebony for the back and sides. And then some really cool inlay. I can't remember exactly which one this one is, but I believe it's like a newspaper that's cast in resin. If you've ever worked with Wenge, you know that it's really, really difficult to work with. So to get that kind of clean, those clean sweeping lines is no joke. So that's, to me, you get extra points. this is just wild. Like, I don't even know where to start with the insides of this guitar. You've got these kind of angles in the rim assembly, which I believe are all mitered together. That's not easy to do. All right, let's give this a listen. I love the look of this, it's so nice. First thing to say with this, like, this is not a big guitar, but you can hear that it has a really loud, present, full, resonant voice. It's got that really lush overtone content, a really modern voice. Love that. Nice playing too. All right, next up we've got Ocean guitars, and this was one I was really excited about. When I first saw this going through all the submissions, I was like, wow, this is different. This is really fun. Love this headstock design straight out the gate. The construction here is just magnificent. I love this neck heel. That is not an easy thing to construct and to get right, especially in a pale wood too. It's done a really beautiful job of that. And I just love the idea of being able to look right through and into the guitar. Purple heart back and sides, maple neck, maple fingerboard, maple bridge, amazing. They've been building for 18 years and it shows because the work is super clean. God, I love this headstock design, really pretty. Let's give it a listen. You're in for a treat with this. This is a special sounding guitar. Feels like it's super lightly constructed. It almost doesn't look like it's got any finish on it, which is really interesting. Love that. Go check out those guitars, Ocean Guitars on Instagram. Very cool. All right, so next up we've got Paolo of Futone Guitars out in Portugal, a builder for 8 years. And these are just, you know, if you look at these straight away and you're like, okay, this is different. Like, what is going on here? It's like semi-hollow, but like, and that back, come on, the carving that's gone into that, the shaping, it's beautiful. Let's give this a listen. Super nice sound. Such a cool look. So the Infinity comes to create a bridge between hollow bodies and archtop guitars, inspired by the Infinity symbol. It's completely carved and hollowed by hand, resulting in a 2.5 kilogram guitar. That is light. That is really light. It's kind of crazy light. All right, so we've got two guitars left. If you're enjoying this kind of content, make sure to hit like and subscribe and all of those kind of things. It really does help out the channel, helps us grow and make more videos like this. So we've got two guitars left. So next we're gonna check out Bastien Berlot over in France. And this is a Luthier that I've been following on Instagram for quite a long time now. Beautiful work, like really clean. Classical guitars. I don't know a huge amount about classical guitars, but I know a pretty one when I see one. I mean, come on, look at the top on that for a start. That is just absolutely beautiful. The medullary ray in that is just perfect. I want to know where that wood came from. So this, to me, really stands out. It's from a different guitar, but I just love that white on black look. I love that headstock too. It's kind of got the classical nods, but then you've got the little bit of inlay, you've got those notches, and then this crazy kind of internal framework or structure. I just love the look of that, and that bridge is just so beautifully shaped and carved. Just such gorgeous work. So unfortunately we don't have any sound for this guitar, so make sure you go and check out Bastien's work. All right, finally the last guitar. This comes from Jackie Walray. Hope I'm pronouncing that right. I think I am, I googled it. 33 years building, and he's also a teacher of instrument building as well. This is Jackie's Beetle project, creating a new instrument altogether. It certainly looks pretty snazzy. I mean, come on, look at that. This is inspired by the Beetle car. You can see that the parallels there. And I just love this. This is another one of those guitars where you just look at it and you think, okay, how was this made? Where did they start? How long did this take them? And what does this sound like? I love the look of that. It's got a beautiful top on it. The spalting, I absolutely love this. I'm really intrigued to see what this one sounds like. love the headstock on this guitar too. Great sound. Thank you to everybody who submitted. There was loads of you, and unfortunately we couldn't get to everyone because the video would have been about 3 weeks long. I did just want to give a few honourable mentions. So Thompson and Ball guitars, Cray guitars, Sam Houston, Molyneux guitars, what's up Dan, Daly, Luthier, hey Mike, Black Creek guitars, and Brian Itzkin guitars as well. Thank you for just being supportive, awesome, wonderful humans. So hopefully you enjoyed this kind of content. If you want to see us do more of it, you know what to do. Hit us up in the comment section, and we'll see you next time. Peace!